Happy Mercedesing. In this video, we're going to be speaking about the EHA. To be more precise, about how we're going to connect the EHA to measure milliamps on it. If any of my videos helped you repair your car, then please hit the button thanks. If you, yeah, you want to be the first one to watch my videos as they're fully uploaded, then become a supporter of the channel. And if you want to watch the service manuals, then become a donor. Thanks. And if you would be kind, please, to support my Patreon, then here is the link to that site. And see you there also. Because at a certain point, you will have to measure your current on the EHA to see how your ECU is operating. This is one of the things you will have to do when you check the electronic part of your system, which I'm going to be speaking about a bit more in the next video. So, you will have to, as I have said, measure the milliamps just to see how your ECU is behaving, or is it behaving at all. And then I have a video in which I was showing you how to do that with these alligator leads, with these. You need three of them. But if you want a more elegant way to do that, you can do it with this thing. So, if you don't know where to find the connector, this is the connector of your EHA. You can find it on some junkyard. Someone can sell you this one. If you don't, I'm going to leave you the number of this connector so you can order it online on eBay. And you will need this one as well. I will put you the number of this one. This one is specifically from the outside temperature sensor on R129. And there you can find it cheap on eBay for $9. Something like that. Well, if you do not have them, you will also have to find crimps and then to connect them with these connectors. So, let's see how we connect these two and this whole setup, as I called it, setup. Let's see how we connect it to the car. Shall we? So look, as you remove your connector from the EHA, you will see here the numbers 1, 2. And let me show you what actually happens. As you connect this connector, number one of the connector goes to the pin number 2 on your EHA and vice versa. And now we have to connect them. In order to connect them, you will be needing wires. So, as I connected this one, pin number 2, to the, as we put it here, to here it says pin number 2. Pin number 1 is crocodile for my ground, and the positive for my multimeter is this one here. It is going to be, as we connected the left here, as we connected, it's gonna be the left side of the connector. It's gonna be number 1 here. So again, positive pin number 1. Negative, or the ground, also pin number 1 on this female connector. And pin number 2 is gonna be this one here. That's how I connected them. So as you remove your original connector, you're going to stick this one into the original one, and this one into the EHA. So here's the setup. Here, here, and measuring milliamps. Now ignition on, and let's now analyze what is important here. What you see here, this is a very important step, the first one. Ignition on. As you can see on my multimeter, it reads 20 milliamps. Make sure that you get a plus sign. Make sure that you don't get a negative sign, that it says negative 19 or 20 milliamps. In a huge majority of the cars, you will get 20 milliamps for cat versions. For non-cat versions, you will get 10. For V8 engines, you will get 75 milliamps, and so on. But make sure that you get the milliamps without the negative sign. Otherwise, you will get wrong picture of everything. For example, if when the car is running, the milliamps show negative milliamps, that means that your mixture is rich. Positive milliamps show that the mixture is lean. That's why it's important, as you can see here. So if something happens, I was speaking about that, that you get the negative sign, then just swap the places of your leads from the multimeter. Here, 20 milliamps, that's it. Let's start the car. This, what you have seen, was my cold start. And the measurements you take in consideration after 28 seconds. For the cars after September 89. Before, then you can see the readings the right moment. Because the cold start, the first start, lasts for 28 seconds. That's the time during which the catalytic converter is being preheated. Temperature. Yeah. 80. And what you see here now, you just will see that in couple of seconds my car is at the operating temperature. So I just cut my footage and I did not want you to watch at the multimeter for 12 minutes. So the whole footage lasts for approximately 12 minutes. Wow! As you see, this fluctuation, we can see here that the fluctuation is okay. It has to be between negative 3 and 0. So this, in my case, is a good EHA setup. And now what we're going to see, I'm going to improvise the car at 2500 RPM, approximately. Afterwards, I'm going to raise it even more, to up to 3500, and then I'm going to press the accelerator and to improvise the cutoff phase. What you see here, my readings are approximately negative 50 milliamps. Well, the cutoff phase has to be negative 60. Okay, I think I can live with that. Once again, if you liked this video,
please consider subscribing to our YouTube channel and click the bell to be notified when we post new videos.
Then I would kindly ask you not to hit the button skip ad. That is going to help me a lot. And till some next one, happy Mercedes-ing.